Here are some Taylor series examples. First one, find the first four terms of the Taylor series for tangent x at x equals pi over 4. So you do your derivatives here. The function is tangent x. Derivative is secant squared. Second derivative is this. Third derivative is this. And I got these last two from Wolfram Alpha. No need to sit there killing yourself over this because that's not the point of it. Then evaluate it at pi over 4. You get 1, you work this out, you get 2, 4, 16. Then your coefficients of your terms are going to be the kth derivative evaluated at pi over 4, which is what these were, over k factorial. So you come down here and you do that. You have your 1, 2, which was that. That's the first derivative one. That's 1 factorial. You have your x minus a term in there. 4, 16, 2 factorial, 3 factorial. So you reduce that down and you get this. 16 over 6 is 8 over 3. So those are the first four terms. 1, 2, 3, 4. Wolfram Alpha says that the series expansion of tangent x at x equals pi over 4 is this. That lines up our first four terms and they keep going a few more terms. Don't worry about trying to get the pattern for this one. I would not ask this on a test because the pattern is not apparent at all. Here's another example. Find the summation notation form for this series. The book says it this way. Find an expression for the general term of the series and give the range of values for the index. Well, what they're really talking about is find a summation notation. That's what they mean. Okay, so that's what we're going to do. Okay, notice the terms are skipping. There's no x term, there's no x to the third. You cannot skip the integer values in the k counter, or the index of the summation. So you line up your k values above your expression. So here it is. Here's your k, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here's your expression. And then you work on, I started at k equals 0. You can start at 0 or 1, depending on which is easier. I thought when I put in 1, I would add 1, 2, 3, 4. I think it would be a little bit easier to have k equals 0. So I did started with k equals 0, and I went for the coefficients. So the coefficients look like just 1 over 0, 1 factorial, 2 factorial, 3 factorial, 4 factorial. So it's 1 over k factorial for the coefficients. For the powers, here's the k's, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Powers are 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. So it looks like x to the 2k will work. So you put it together, coefficients with the powers, and you get e to the x squared equals k equals 0 to infinity of this. So another question you could ask is, where does it converge? So you do your ratio test. Simplifies down to this. Simplifies down to this. Then you do your limit. Factor out the x. K's are moving. It goes to 0, which is equal to 0 for all x. And 0 is less than 1. Hence, this equals this series for all x values. Now here's an interesting idea here. The regular e to the x series that we've seen before is this, and has this series form. So if you want e to the x squared, you just write out, well, e to any u variable is this 1 over k factorial u to the k. That's what e to the x is. Then you just sub in x squared for the u. That's it. Just put it in there. Put it in there for where it is. Simplify the exponent, you get this. And that's what we got earlier. And some more interesting stuff to this is, let's say you wanted to find this integral of e to the x squared. We said earlier there was no nice closed form for that. But now you know that e to the x squared is this Taylor series. We just showed that. So why don't you just integrate up term by term? Because it's just a sum. So integrate up x cubed over 3, x to the 5th over 5, and you have the 2 factorial down there. That's just a constant. X to the 6th over 7, x to the 7th over 7, times the 3 factorial down there. Just integrate up term by term, and that turns into this series with the pattern there. So the general term is what you get if you integrate 1 over k factorial x to 2k. What I mean is that you would have the 1 over k factorial. You'd add 1 to here and divide by the new exponent. That's what you do. And that's how you get it. So we said there was no nice closed form solution for it. But we do have the series solution, and it's good for all x values. So here it is. You just put, you can evaluate this antiderivative of any x value you want by just sticking it in this series, and that will do it. And that will do it.